Previously on Tribal, we looked at part one of the Rob Zabaknik story. He was a colorful, confrontational character across the first three episodes. Jed was just voted out, and Rob is on the bottom of his tribe. Let's see what's in store for episode four. Zookjai gets back from tribal, and Rob isn't happy.
So you guys happy with your decision?
I didn't feel good to have my name read out loud. It was not unexpected, you guys, but still was like...
Yeah, I figured I'd at least have one person calling my name out.
We had tribal council, and I was pretty shocked with the outcome. To be completely honest, I originally thought that Shean was going to be the one voted off, but just goes to show you, man, nothing's set in stone out here.
The next scene is tree mail, where they receive a dummy for the next reward challenge.
Hey, you lie.
I swear to God there's a dummy over there as big as your ass.
The tribes need to dress up their new tribe member and give it a name. And this seems to be a challenge for Sukjai.
I don't know. I don't care. Blackbeard was a famous pirate.
You need some big, strong warrior name.
Name him Genghis, dude.
Genghis Khan.
Which he was from Afghanistan or something.
Yeah.
Sukjai names it Genghis, and off we go to the reward challenge.
Sukjai, tell me about your new tribe members.
Came up with a warrior named Oterot.
Oterot.
Okay, I guess it's Oterot now. The tribes have to carry the dummy down the beach, through the trees, and back to the finish. Tribes will compete for bananas.
Enough bananas to last a long time.
The challenge starts with Rob being a villain.
Short little Jiffy Probst is like, you know, survivor's ready, go! I ran in front of everybody, and the two dolls were leading against each other, and I leaned my doll against us and like kicked theirs over so that they had to pick it up off the ground. Just a dick move.
Thanks to Rob, Sukjai takes an early lead. They make their way through the trees, and with Rob's lead, they make it to the finish.
See those bananas? We can almost taste them, baby.
Woo! Sukjai! You guys rock!
Woo! Sukjai wins first food reward.
Sukjai wins the bananas, and Rob loves it.
Yeah! So good.
Oh. Yes!
Bananas are my new favorite food, by the way, dude.
That's so good.
After the challenge, they indulge in the reward.
I haven't liked the mushy ones, and I never liked mushy banana. Banana, it was sweet, and it was soft, and it was warm, and so good.
This is the best day I've ever been here.
Yeah, I agree.
Thank you, God, for a triumphant day. You rewarded us with nourishment all of us needed. For this, I give much thanks to the Almighty Lord. Amen.
Along with bananas, Sukjai won a bonus reward. Chickens.
We got chickens, dude. I've never had a chicken before.
We got a continuous source of food right here.
All of us were super excited to see that we had chickens. It's like a food source that'll never go bad. Look at that one, dude.
Rob talks to the chickens and encourages them to lay eggs.
You better not get any ideas to start cock-a-doodle-dooing at 3 a.m. You're gonna get a broken neck. We're gonna check for eggs every day, and I expect there to be eggs. Or somebody's getting axed. Look at me when I'm talking to you. I feel amazing. Nourished, happy, thankful. About every good emotion you could imagine feeling. Things aren't so bad out here, man.
Rob is feeling good going into the immunity challenge, and so is Sukjai.
Check it out. Make it square across the top of that bottom triangle. Make it flat. Just how you had it, baby. You had it right.
And with the help from Rob, Sukjai wins immunity.
Sukjai!
And that means 3 more days for Rob. Episode 4 was a good one for Rob. He didn't make any waves, and Sukjai won both challenges. Let's see what happens next episode. Episode 5 starts with breakfast as Sukjai cooks one of their chickens.
Thank you for giving your life, Mr. Bird.
During the feast, Rob comments on the way Shean eats the chicken.
Yeah. Shean had a feast. She ate lungs and intestines and necks and picked the bones so there's nothing left. I don't know, her eating habits are just repulsive.
gotta be the best.
She licks her fingers too much and tries to reach back in and grab stuff everybody else is eating. It's just gross.
Sheehan then asks Rob if he wants some of the chicken neck.
Ugh.
Neck is gone, I ate it.
You ate the whole neck?
Yeah, it was good.
Moving along from Rob versus Sheehan, we go to Rob versus the Stingray. Sukhchai has the day off, so they decide to enjoy themselves. Some people relaxed, and others... Rob just goes wild in the water. Meanwhile, Penny, Jake, and Aaron are just chilling off to the side.
I'm chilling here.
As Rob comes back to the shore, he has no idea that he's a few steps away from a stingray.
When we heard Rob scream, man, that's nothing unusual for Rob, so nobody thought too much about it early.
Rob steps on the stingray and lets out screams of agony, but his tribe mates don't even bat an eye. They think he's just doing normal Rob stuff. After all, we have heard this scream quite a bit.
God! Oh! Yes!
Rob stumbles his way to the beach and lays down. He soaks his foot in some hot water and explains to his tribe what happened.
Okay, the wave came and I kicked, and when my foot went back, something came and bit me. I don't know what out there has a mouth big enough to bite me and put a mark like this on me.
Jake tells Rob he probably stepped on a stingray, and Rob tells Jake how much it hurts.
Damn it, it hurts!
He's like a little baby. He's like throwing a little ow, it hurts! Throwing a little temper tantrum on the ground.
Sheehan tells Rob that sea urchin bites really hurt, and Rob doesn't like that comment.
You ever been stung by one? And she goes, no.
I've been stung by a jellyfish.
And I wanted to say, well, then how would you know? Shut up and go get me some water.
And there you have it. Rob and the Stingray. The number 3 spot on the Funny Win 15, and for good reason. Moving on to the Immunity Challenge, where the tribes have to sort different types of fish. Chuigong gets it done really quickly and wins immunity, which means Rob's going to Tribal Council tonight.
Sukhchai, see you guys tonight at Tribal Council. Something's going on.
After the challenge, Rob is pissed. He's not mad about the challenge or the stingray. He's still mad about the way Sheehan ate the chicken.
The most upsetting thing about it is like the reward when we had utensils and she was using her fingers. She's a girl too. Give me a break, dude.
No.
Who the hell would take her on?
As you can see, Rob is trying to get Sheehan voted out. But the rest of Sukhchai has other plans. And now we go to Rob's second tribal council of the season. Jeff asks Rob what he thinks of the other tribe.
They seem like a happy bunch of people. Good for them, man.
You guys think you're stronger than Chuigong?
For sure, without a doubt. Come on, bro.
Come on, bro. Who's sitting at tribal council?
Now it's time to vote.
Penny, you're first.
Rob votes for Sheehan and gives us one of the best voting confessionals while doing it.
Sorry, girl. You get on my nerves and I don't like being around you. Nothing personal.
Rob lists 2 personal things that he doesn't like about Sheehan, but it's okay, because he said nothing personal afterwards. After Rob's classic confessional, Jeff reads the votes, and once again, Rob is on the wrong side of them.
Fourth vote. Steph, that's enough. You need to bring your torch.
Stephanie gets voted out, and Rob loses another ally. That's it for episode 5. Rob survived tribal council and an attack from Mother Nature. He tried to get Sheehan voted out, but ultimately failed, and his only remaining ally went home. Nothing personal. Episode 6 starts out with a bang. Rob is hungry. Ken notices this and is not pleased.
Right there is a good one.
Dude, relax. Over it.
Unbelievable.
What's the deal? Are we eating the bananas? Are we not eating the bananas? How's this work?
I don't know. We're waiting on the bananas.
I was hungry, so I had a banana. I don't think anyone wants to have to ask somebody if they can have a banana. We want them. We're going to enjoy them. We worked really hard for that food.
Ken and Rob get into another argument, but this time, Shein gets involved.
Dude, I'm not complaining about that, but
yeah, I don't want to argue over banana. I'm hungry, I'm going to eat a banana. I don't even want to hear the word.
I'm not trying to squabble about bananas, but like, we're just trying,
right,
I'm just
trying to figure
out. And there we have it, the original banana etiquette. You may remember James from Heroes vs. Villains in a similar situation.
But in my world, if your ass is hungry, you go get a banana.
But it happened here first, and it's all thanks to Rob. Now it's time for the reward challenge, where tribes must catch a ball in a basket to score points. The first tribe to 5 wins a Thai feast.
Wait, all the fixins? All the fixins?
With all the fixins!
Yeah!
The challenge starts out great for Rob. But after a timeout and switch by Chewygon, Rob now has to face Big Ted. And this doesn't go well.
Play scores! Blocked by Big Ted, no score! Chewygon scores!
The score is now all tied up at 4, and next point wins. Sukchai calls a timeout, and Rob is a little heated.
Am I the only one that scores on you guys?
You're the only one that's getting them. That's your job. What are you making
okay,
them like,
listen,
oh, nobody's hoping?
Listen, time out.
Don't start fighting for me, punk. Why don't you go over there?
Penny gets everyone in order, and off we go.
I'm going to start launching them in the middle, and I want all 4 of your butts run into the middle, so let's get them in the baskets.
Step back out. Sukchai scores! Sukchai wins, reward!
Sukchai wins. And Jeff gives Rob the MVP.
Clearly a good team effort. I gotta say, Rob, you carried this one all
yeah,
the way.
He did.
4 out of 5 balls, not bad. A feast awaits, guys, this way.
After the hard-fought challenge, Sukchai enjoys their reward.
You guys, today we worked so hard. After all the drama this morning, this is honestly better than anything I could have ever imagined.
Rob was definitely a key factor in our reward challenge and us having that fabulous Thai food.
Moving along, we go to the immunity challenge, where tribes must complete a 21 puzzle. Rob sits out of this challenge, so his fate is in the hands of Sukchai. Sukchai loses, and all Rob can do is watch.
Chewygon wins immunity.
And this means tribal council tonight. Sukchai gets back to camp, and everyone is
really bummed out about that because we really wanted to win it.
This is the first time I've been upset about any challenge we've lost.
So they decide to sit around, drink wine, and let their feelings pour out.
The last night together as a family, guys. 6 of us.
Sucks.
Yeah, it doesn't feel good, that's for sure.
Rob talks about his experience and how it's changed him for the better.
There's no words that can describe this experience. When it's all said and done, you know what I'm gonna tell people about this? You know what, it changed my whole outlook on life.
He then tells us what's most important to him.
Life is so important right now to me. And family, you guys, the most important thing in life. The people you love, people who love you just as much.
He tells us the perspective he's gained.
I never imagined I'd get out here and really warm up to cherishing bananas.
And makes peace with his rivals, Ken and Shein.
I'll tell you one thing that I never imagined, that I'd be hanging out with a skateboard freak.
Can I just say something? You and I have had our differences, Rob, but I think you're a really, really good guy.
Now it's time for Tribal Council. Even though it looks like the end is near for Rob, he keeps a positive attitude. Jeff asks Rob about the immunity challenge and how he felt.
It was kind of hard, because for me, sitting on the sidelines and watching them lose and then seeing their reaction afterwards, it was tough. And I started thinking how thankful I was to be here and how amazing this experience has been for me. Absolutely amazing.
Now it's time to vote.
Penny, you're first.
We've seen Rob vote for Shianne every time so far, and he will keep that tradition. But this time, what he says is personal.
No hard feelings, baby. I had to vote for somebody. We had our ups and downs, but I'm definitely glad I got to know you.
In the end, Shianne will get the last laugh and delivers her own iconic confessional.
There's an old proverb. A wise man knows much but says little. A fool knows little but says far too much.
It's now time for the moment of truth for our skateboarding buddy. Jeff starts reading the votes.
Shianne.
And when the votes come up, Rob, he gives us his most iconic line of them all.
Rob, two B's. Two B's, guys.
The rest of the votes are read, and sadly, Rob is voted out.
That's enough. Thank you for bringing George. Rob, your tribe has spoken.
Thanks, brother. Much love, dude. You guys are cool.
I would like to embrace this moment and tell everybody how absolutely thankful I am. This experience has forever broadened my horizons. I leave here happy because I've already won. I love you guys.
And that's it for the Rob Zabaknik story. He was a very entertaining character, and he made every scene he appeared in interesting, to say the least.
Let me see your hands.
He gave us some iconic moments. Legendary confessionals.
We definitely got all the hot chicks.
No.
Sorry, girl. You get on my nerves and I don't like being around you. Nothing personal.
Repulsive.
And in my opinion, one of the best story arcs in the old school era.
Damn it! Her! And family, you guys, the most important thing in life. The people you love. People who love you just as much. That's what this is about.
Thanks for watching. These videos are so much fun to make, and hopefully you enjoy them. Have a good one, and I'll see you next time at Tribal.
When you see that now, what's your reaction?
Oh man, completely embarrassed. I mean, there's times in my life I've acted immature, but I've never been in front of 2 million people, or 20 million people, excuse me. It was pretty hardcore to watch it amongst my family and have everybody like, were you choking that guy? What the hell's the matter with you?